Hello, everyone. How's it going? Dr. Incompetent here, and let's play some SpellRogue, shall we? Well, we're playing this brand new turn-based, dice-based roguelike here for the turn-based festival, and I'm really excited to try it out. I am honored to be a part of the turn-based fest. It's been fantastic so far. We did Desktop Dungeons Rewind yesterday. It was great, and this game looks amazing. I was kind of looking through the available games that I could choose from to play, and this one just caught my eye. Nobody had taken it yet, so I snatched it up, excited to play it, because I do like Dicey Dungeons, and just, you know, if it's similar to that, I don't know, but I like dice games, I like card games, I like roguelikes, and it just seemed like this is going to be a pretty good fit. So let's check it out and see what it's all about. So I'm going to start a brand new game right here. Thank you, Guidelight Games, for allowing me to try out the game and for making it. Here we go. Okay, so I can be only this center choice right now. And it looks like I'm Morgan. I'm a water wizard. I'm assuming this is first level, 0 out of 500 experience. And my loadout gives me a signature spell of Fluctuate and some support spells of Ice Spear and Foamy Bulwark. So that looks fantastic. I could, choose a different loadout as I level up. So it's kind of roguelite in that element where, you know, it starts with, let's just say it starts with some locked elements and lets you kind of open up new possibilities as you go, but then the game itself is randomized, like Slay the Spire, perhaps. So let's go ahead and take a look. All right, Act 1, Deadwoods, and wow. Okay, so yes, the game board looks very much like, a Slay the Spire, or I suppose at this point, Darkest Dungeon 2 game path, and that's fantastic. I love I love tabletop games, so I love stuff that kind of looks like that. I love making these choices and seeing, you know, which path to take is the best. Alex, good evening, my friend. Good to see you. So I'm excited to roll. Let's go ahead and see which way. Indeed, Alex. Indeed. I started 30 minutes later than normal for streaming to accommodate my slot here in the turn-based fest, which started at 10 p.m. Eastern. So I just figured I'd start the whole thing at 10 to match up with the slot for the schedule better. All right, I'm going to go over here, and they're both normal battles. So I'm going to go to the left just because this looks pretty cool to me. I don't know. Hey, Dome Reaper, what's up, my friend? Yes, happy turn-based fest indeed. It's going great. Thank you for asking. I hope you're doing well. I'm just trying out SpellRogue here, and this is the battlefield. First of all, let's just talk a little bit about the presentation, what I see here. I think the art is, it is a little tricky, isn't it? Dome, I always struggle with these kind of things, and I just go for it, and I hope for the best. But I'm glad I got lucky that time. So I love the swamp in the background. I love how this mushroom dude looks, and I like how Morgan, my wizard, looks as well. So everything seems very clear. Looks like I have some consumable slots on the top. You can see my health in the upper left. The enemy's intents are listed right above his head. Like Insulated Spire, so he's going to do 4 damage to my face. It looks like I have some gold to buy things from shops. I have shards, which can be used to upgrade spells and relics. Okay, very good. This is, I guess, I don't know what that is yet. These are the settings, and here's what's happening. I have rolled a 4, a 4, and a 3, and then these are what I can do down here, I guess. I could re-roll dice. I could deal X damage where I guess X is the amount of dice that I use. I know, Dome. Me too. But I don't think... I think this is a, you know, old school, you buy it all at one time kind of a thing. And not microtransactions. But boy, you never know, do you? All right. And then this says it... I block. Okay. So let's see how I understand this. These charges say that it indicates how many times this spell can be used this turn, and it's going to do X damage. So let me just, what if I took this and put it right here? Mana socket requires dice with value higher than or equal to 3. Okay, so this is like Dicey Dungeons. I can do this, and I can do damage to this guy. But let's think about this. We know that the corrupt brute, this mushroom man here, is going to do 4 damage to us. So we can just see that. So we should definitely probably block first. Now, the amount of actions that we get to take is just how many dice we get per turn. So I'm going to block for 4, okay? And you can see that my block appears at the right end of my hit point bar here. This way we know that we've guaranteed to, like, lock in protection against whatever this guy is going to do, and now we can dedicate our time to blasting this dude. So I'm going to use... I'm going to reroll... this is tough. This is fun. This is where the gambling comes in. So... yeah, it is really interesting, isn't it, Dome Reaper? So here's the deal. Both of these dice will work for Ice Spear. I can use Ice Spear to do 3 damage and then 4 damage. I can use it twice, and we could do 7 total damage. Now, I could use Fluctuate and re-roll my 3 and just hope to spike a 6, but I get to use this more than once. So let's just do this first and see what we get. And so we got a 2, right? But we can re-roll the 2 and get a 4. So, you know, we gambled a little bit there, but... we had, a 75% chance of improving that 3. My math is a little bit off, but I think it was like a 50-50 that we re-rolled a 3, 4, 5, or 6. No. 4, 5, or 6 was 50-50. 1, 2, and 3 was the other side of that. And then we got to do it twice. So we had really good odds of improving a 3. I think 75%, because it's a 50 twice, but anyway, that's just my poor poker math coming in handy, or betraying me mathematically. I know it's pretty rough, but we're going to go ahead and just do this then. So now, we're going to do 4 damage, and you get this big pointer, and we're going to point at that guy, and boom, we threw an ice spear right through that guy. So you could see we're doing our water magic, and we're blasting people in the face. And we're going to blast like that. Bam. So we've done 8 damage. And this guy's got 11 health left. We're going to end the turn. He's going to hit us, but we blocked it. And we rolled again. I love her rolling animation, and I love the rolling sound effect, by the way. It's awesome. Okay. So let's see this. Yeah, Dome Reaper, it's a great take on, like, you know, you get that Slay the Spire feel, but you're not... you don't have a deck, right? So you're not drawing random cards, but you're using dice with the combat. And it reminds me of Dicey Dungeons, but it's different than Dicey Dungeons as well. So let's see here. What do I want to do? He's going to do 4 damage again. So first of all, let's just check for lethal. Hey, Snack, good evening. Doesn't it feel like that, Snack? Exactly. And I love Dicey Dungeons, so let's see how this goes. And let's see what changes, you know, in terms of the formula, like what they did. It is definitely a radically different art style. It is not like a humorous game show. This is like deep fantasy. So, if I want to make sure... if we do lethal, we get to act before this guy, so we can kill him. So I could do 6, I could do 10, right? Yeah, isn't it cool, Dome Reaper? So I'm going to go ahead and re-roll this. And I'm going to do it again. Hey, Advo. Good evening, my friend. It's Slay the Spire with dice. And that's unfair, but I mean, you know, in terms of the archetype, it feels that way. Yeah, Snack, I agree with you. I played Floppy Knights a little bit because, like you, I have Xbox Game Pass, so it was free on Xbox Game Pass, and Floppy Knights was great. And it was this, it seemed like the exact same artist or art style as Dicey Dungeons, and it was also really cool. There's just so many good games. I mean, gosh, now that you mention it, Snack, I should play Floppy Knights again. I think I only played it for, you know, two or three videos. I'm going to reroll this, and we got unlucky. We got what we had before, and I'm just going to play it safe. There's no urgency here, so I'm just going to block and then do 6 damage to this guy and then try to kill him next turn. This, I mean, I can overblock, I guess. Why not? But so this has taken 3 turns, and we've got lethal right here, so let's just do it. Dead. Victory. And, all right, so we got a spell draft. Okay. Oh, cool. So maybe it is kind of more like a deck builder in a way. Like, I'm getting a choice between 3 new items to equip. I know, Dome. Sometimes I forget to go face, and I always regret it. Let's see what these choices are. That's right, Snack. It is the place. Glaciate. Okay. So if you right-click, you can zoom in on them. And let's see. Glaciate. Oh, I see. No. What you do is when you right-click on it, you can see how it levels up. Oh, wow. And unlike Dicey Dungeons or Sway to Spire, things can level up 3 times. So that's pretty wild. So Glaciate is like a persistent block ability. So you get whatever you put into it of block that turn and the next turn with only 1 charge. Level 2, same ability, gives you 2 charges. And then level 3 gives you X plus 3 for 2 turns. I mean, it's a great blocking card, right? So this is a good block card. Akashic Aqua, let's see. It takes 2 dice, but then gain 7 block on a 7, roll a die. So you have to give any 2 dice here and get 7 blocks. So you could have 2 ones, right? But if you have a 7, if you have a 6 and a 1 or any combination of dice that adds up to 7, the way I'm reading this is that you get to roll one of those dice back into your pool. And then this one is green, which looks like it means it might be... I don't know if this means it's just a piece of equipment or if it means like it's rare, you know, like it's better than the rest of these. So let's see what this does just in terms of analysis. So this is the Tether Azure, and it says hold to die until next turn. At the end of your turn, you deal 3 damage to front opponent. So interesting. So it's like, hey, Firebird Lover, good evening, my friend. Yeah, I think you're right. Uncommon? Exactly. Don't they all do that? The same, like, green, blue, purple, or, you know, whatever, something like that? Absolutely. So the question then, if this is uncommon, you know, I'm trying to think about this in my mind. So you take a die off the board for 1 turn that's from 3 to 6, and you do 3 damage at the end of the turn to a target that you don't get to choose. I mean, it's the front target, so if there's multiple enemies, it's harder to aim. But the bonus is, next round, then I think you'll have 4 dice to work with, or whatever your dice is, plus 1, I think. Right, so it's kind of like 3 damage now, an extra die next turn? Does that... I mean, I think that's how to interpret hold a die, but I don't know. I'm going to experiment with this just because the other cards are defensive. And if, you know, when I play a lot of these games, like Slay the Spire, or, you know, pretty much any kind of deck building roguelike, you need, like, the beginning of the game is usually a DPS race. Like, you need damage more than you need blocking up front. But maybe this game is different. I don't know. I'm going to take this because it's just an offensive spell, and we'll get a 26 gold. Okay, so I kind of want to see what this event is, and so I'm going to go this way to move toward it. All right. There we go, rolling up. So, I mean, right away it's different than Dicey Dungeons, because in that game you don't get to upgrade your abilities quite so frequently. You know, like, you change your loadout as often. I don't know how many times I'm going to get to do that, but that was pretty amazing. I mean, I already have now a new choice to make. I really like the art style. I love how this guy looks. Now, he's going to do 4 damage to us and apply a weak to us, which means we get 1 damage per stack this turn. Wow, so it's just 1 damage off the top. What's this mean? Berserker. Gain 1 power whenever attacked by spells. Uh-oh. Increase damage by 1+1 per stack for rest of the combat. Well, now I feel terrible for not going defensive, because this guy is, like, kind of a jerk. I know, Snack. He's got Trog all over the place with that berserker power. Hey, Joseph Jack. Good evening, my friend. Good to see you. All right. So let's go ahead then and lock down the 3 right here for that. He wants to do 4, so let's block for 4. And then, I'm going to get greedy. Okay, backfired, and roll again, and it got worse. So that was very unfortunate to roll a 1 and a 2. So then instead, I guess we just have to block. That's fine, whatever. We won't make him go berserk anyway. End turn. No, we did make him go berserk. You see he did 5 damage right there. So this guy, because of his berserker, like, the slower we try to kill this guy, the more powerful he gets. So if we try to go 1,000 cuts on this guy, he's going to embarrass us. So we need to just do as much damage as we can. Hey, Robert, good evening, my friend. Good to see you. So let's see how we do that, right? He's going to do 5 damage to our face, but we were right about how we read that. So we did get 4 dice this turn, and it was a 3 again. So I can just put a 3 on lockdown to do 3 damage, but I need to do more damage to this guy's face. First of all, I want to fluctuate this 1. Okay, that was a huge upgrade, but we can't block with it. Let me upgrade it. That's greedy if I do it that way. No, I think we got to go. I think we have to risk it for the biscuit. We're just going to do 6 damage to this guy's face. Oh, Robert, it's doing great, my friend. Thank you for asking. I'm so happy to have gotten multiple people, have a little base going. Joseph, you sure can block an attack. But the issue with my block is that this, the only defensive spell I have right now is Foamy Bulwark, and it will only accept a die of values 1 to 4. So I can put in this 2 or this 3, for example, but they won't fully block that. So, you know, I'm going to reroll this 2. All right, and that's terrifying. So we ended up doing much worse. We're just going to take some damage. I'm going to go ahead and just hit this guy in the face. We're just going to take damage. That's all there is to it. And I'm going to put this, I'd rather hurt the guy than just block for, you know, for 3. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so we did take some damage. Oh, now he's doing 5 dice too. All right, we got to just kill this guy right away. But we do. We have plenty of damage to kill this guy. We're going face. All right, great. Okay. So we did take 7 damage in that fight, which is unfortunate. And I'm going to go ahead and... Okay, we get a consumable, smoke screen, gain a dodge. And we got some gold. And we got another spell draft. I mean, this is so great. So each battle, we're getting a brand new ability to use. We're really, really filling out. I don't know if you get unlimited of these or how many you can have at a time. C-word. And by the way, one of the things I really have to do when thinking about this game is appreciate the fact that... Hey, Dome Reaper. Have a great night, my friend. Thank you for stopping in, and I absolutely hope you enjoy the game when you try it out. Megan, good evening. How's it going? Thanks for liking the stream. So, what I have to get my head around as I try out this game for the Turn-Based Fest is that these aren't like in Slay the Spire. It's not like I'm going to draw these, maybe. I just have this. So whatever I take, I'll be able to use it whenever I want. So that increases the value so dramatically. Now, do I want to poison things? Do I want to gain a hailstorm? What's a hailstorm? Ice Fury. Gives +1 per stack. Interesting. Or Sea Ward, which gives you 2x block. So this is just strictly a better block. I'm just going to take an... Oh, okay, actually. Well, here you go. When you mouse over it, now it tells you it's uncommon. So we were right, everybody. And by we, I mean you were right. It's uncommon. So I think having a defense... Even though I can only use this once, a double block is pretty good. Seeing as how that last fight, I didn't have enough block. I know, Snack. I was really close because that it would be fun to mess around with that ability to stack up damage like that. I kind of just went for the uncommon block because to balance my deck, but you're probably right that that would have been more powerful. Now, I could go fight an elite and see what that's all about, or I could go to an event. I kind of want to just get killed by an elite. Why not? All right. Oh, gosh. The enemies are... Boy, the difficulty level. I'm not fighting mushrooms anymore. So this guy, he gains a growth. And he gains power based on his growth at the start of each round. And he increases his direct damage dealt by +1 on the stack for the rest of this combat. All right, so he's already at 1. But he's not going to hurt me right now. He's only growing, so we need to put all of our energy into just doing damage to this guy's face. So I'm going to lock up a die on tether because it's insane, and then I'm going to re-roll this one. Need to re-roll that again. Okay, it's better than nothing. All right, so we're going to just hit this guy for Ice Spear. But yeah, I think we definitely need some more attack because we're running low. Okay. All right, so he wants to do 6 damage right off the cuff. And we need to kill this guy fast. But he's not doing anything else but doing 6 damage this turn. So honestly, I could just put a 3 right here and block everything. But let's just see if we can come up with lethal. I don't think... The only way I would have lethal is if I had 2 6s. If I had 2 6s to put into Ice Spear, that's 12, and then I could tether something and do 3 to get 15. But I'm not there right now. So because of that, I'm going to actually put a 3 into C-Word, just full block, do all the damage right here, and then we'll tether a 3 and do... 4. So he's going to be at 2. So we should be able to kill him automatically this turn. just by taking the die. And it's good to know, by the way. So tether, the die that you tether does not get re-rolled. It's set. So when it says hold a die, you hold it at that value. So we hold it at a 3, which means I can just ice spear this guy and he's gone. So that time we took no damage. So let's go back to attack for sure. All right. So let's see. What spell do we think will do the best for us attack-wise? So Ice Blast says on a deal 7 damage. On a 7, roll a die back. Okay, so it takes 2 dice to do 7 damage. This says gain 2 rain. At the start of each turn, reduce all countdown spells by the amount of rain and remove 1 stack. And it's unrestorable. Starts combat with a full charge but cannot be restored in any way. Restore its charge when the rain stops. Huh. Yeah, Robert, it is cool. There's a lot to think about. I don't understand what rain means. Like, why I would... Is this defensive? Is this to, like, erase damage over time that the enemy's putting on me? This game is early access, Robert, and I got it as part of the turn-based festival. The developers are letting me try it out. So I don't know how much it is. It's on Steam right now, but I don't know if it's available beyond early access, and if it's even available for testing outside of that. And then Water Vortex says, on odd, you gain a barrier, and a barrier gain 1 block per stack at the end of your turn, or power up. I think I'll take Ice Blast just to have some more damage, but here we go. Okay. So now this is where we actually have reached the capacity. And the question is, do we want to roll something in or out? So I think I'll roll out Ice Blast, or a Foamy Bulwark, actually, for Ice Blast, because Sea Ward is just a more efficient Foamy Bulwark, right? Like, it doesn't have 2 charges, but, like, for 1 die, I'm doing double. So it just seems a strict improvement. Now, it does put a limit on how much I can block, but I like having more offense right now. And then we can spend this currency, the shard, to unlock more abilities. So that's pretty sweet. So I'm just going to put this in my inventory and close this up. And now, that being said, oh wow, look at this. You could spend shards to get more dice rolled per combat. That seems insane. So I would like to have an extra die, right, each turn. I'm going to fight an elite, actually. So against an elite, it might be wise to have another defensive ability, but I think I'm just going to go this way and see what happens. Now, I do have my consumable. Wow, look at this guy. He does look elite. He looks terrifying. This says gain 1 dodge. Avoid all damage from the next spell attack. Persist through rounds. Interesting. He is going to summon some reinforcements. Yikes. So he has 60 hit points. So this guy is enormous, and he's going to summon reinforcements, which is not what I ever want to see. Okay. I think I just lock that and then just hit the guy for a bunch of damage. Okay, so now he's made some little dudes behind him, and they're going to apply power. So that's actually terrifying. So they're going to what? Power him up? Summon units die instantly if there's no leader. So it says apply 2 power. To who? To themselves? Hopefully they're just buffing themselves, actually. Now remember, tether does the damage to the front opponent. Okay, we have a 7 handy for Ice Blast, so we should definitely do that. Gosh, I think I'm going to kill one of these guys. It might be dumb, but I'm going to put a 7 in Ice Blast, because we'll get a die back, and we can just take this dude out. And it re-rolls when you put it back. Actually, that means we can kill this guy and get the die back again. So I'm going to do this. Yeah, Ice Blast is really good. And then he wants to do 9, so I'm just going to block. Oh, 4 or less. Right. I think blocking for 6 is fine. And then just do this. Get the extra die. You can see here that, you know, it's going to show me when I mouse over end turn. You can see that it shows I'm going to go down to 50 and it's going to go down to 43. Okay, so he's going to do 5 and summon 1 dude. And I'm okay with that. Ice Blast is also cool because I can just throw in these 2 terrible ones and do 7 damage, which is not bad at all. But I'm going to fluctuate these. I'm going to reroll. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and let me reroll that. There you go. So now we have a 7 for Ice Blast. Oh, we got a 6. Very good. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and block for 4. And Ice Spear this guy's face. And tether this 5. So he's going to summon. We're going to take some damage here, but only 1. Okay. And here we go. All right, we have a 5-5-5 and a 6. Now he's going to do 4 damage twice, which is a ton. And all of these are actually too high for this, which is distressing. I don't have lethal. I don't see a path to it. So I'm just going to kill this guy so he doesn't do 4 damage. So that's preventing 4 damage. I'm going to reroll a 5. Okay. And reroll this other 5. Wow, that's exactly what I wanted. Okay, so I can put a 4 in here and block fully. I could put the 4 and the 3 in the Ice Blast to do 7 damage and reroll a die, but I don't have Fluctuate anymore, and I'm not guaranteed to be able to block, so I'd like to just block full and then tether this 3 and do 6 damage with Spear. Okay. Alright, so we block all his damage. And what's he doing now? He's going to apply 2 marked and 2 cursed. So this is basically makes us vulnerable. We'll take 50% more damage and all of our dice will lose a value. So this is terrible, but if we can kill this guy right now, we don't have to worry about it. And how much damage do we have? We have enough right here. He has 18, right? So I have 11 plus 7. I have exactly lethal. So all I have to do is do this. 6. 5 is 11. And then any 2 dice to do 7 with that. Take that. Yes. Alright, so awesome. So because we beat an elite, we got an artifact. Wow, look at this. This game is sweet. Alright, a silver hauberk, which would give us health reduced loss by 1. So it's just like 1 mitigation. Or a dousing rod, which says when moving, you gain 10 gold. Again, this is green. This is common, it appears. Hey, thanks, Advo. I'd like reducing damage. I always like that. It's probably a weak choice. The money might be good because it's early, but I'm going to do this, and let's see what spells we can get. Ooh. Whoa, we found a rare. I know, Snack. Wouldn't I go everywhere if I could just get that extra money? So you're saying you'd go Gozag, Snack, is what you're saying. All right. Extract. Extract says deal 12 damage on a heal on... Wow, look at this. So this is like in Dicey Dungeons. It's a countdown. Oh, this is what rain is for. I just didn't understand rain well enough. So rain is for reducing these kinds of cards that you chip away at with multiple dice. So this means every time I hit this, I'm going to do 12 damage, and if I kill it, I'll heal. So that's pretty good, but it's not... I don't know. I mean, maybe I should take it because it's a rare. It does let you heal yourself. Isn't that right, Snack? The capitalistic god? But I don't know. I really don't. It really is, right? Like... then... hey, you know what, Firebird? I could, right? Like, I'm not... even though we got uncommon, uncommon, rare... it does, Snack. Whatever the value is takes off the value. So a 5 takes off 5, a 6 takes off 6. So, it's true, Firebird. Right, so... it's like, if I put a 6 and a 5 in here... the nice thing about... something like Extract is that it lets you set it up so like you can kind of whittle down. But the concern for me is this. Given my current loadout, like given my current deck, what would I replace? You know what I mean? Like what would I want to take out? Weak makes, I'll show you. But, you know, I feel like Fluctuate is fantastic. But maybe you know, if you wanted to go just harder, you would take it out.